Neversong is a 2D puzzle platformer from Atmos Games, previously titled Once Upon a Coma. You play as Pete, a young boy who falls into a coma in the midst of the kidnapping of his best friend Ren by a frightening and shadowy man known as Dr. Smile. Upon waking, Pete seeks to find her, but must now contend with a neighborhood devoid of all adults, needing the help of the children left behind who all have varying ways of dealing with the situation. The story is short but well-paced. The macabre tone set by the superb storybook cutscenes is balanced by the more whimsical cast of NPC children you interact with, some of whom catch you off guard with their dark humor, or even darker sensibilities, and never fail to add levity or weight to the adventure when exchanging dialogue. The plot itself is a rather compelling mystery, but certain aspects at the start don't hold up once you reach the conclusion. You can find and collect cards throughout the world that give short descriptions of characters, monsters, or items. Though they provide nice flavor text, it feels like a missed opportunity to provide missing lore and details for a world I was pretty invested in. Traversal and combat are simplistic but well designed. Pete can run, jump, and unlock additional abilities, like swinging, to navigate further out of the neighborhood. Ren's baseball bat acts as Pete's weapon and has some traversal uses as well, like cutting down bombs to clear blockages. Puzzle solutions are routinely a mix of traversal and information provided by NPCs or the environment that can at times feel like stalling, but ultimately help the sense of satisfaction upon completion. Combat doesn't feel necessary, however. Outside of whacking enemies, which provides great feedback, encounters are a nuisance. This is largely due to the generous range that enemies can hurt you from, but also because of a general lack of threat. That is until later in the game, where the threat from enemies is much higher, but Pete's level of mobility remains the same. Boss fights are a bit more complex, but stand apart due to their context in the narrative. I personally wouldn't have minded if those were the only times combat was involved. I was much more engaged by the eerie aesthetic, which the art design and music helped cultivate. The stark differences between the themes for the starting neighborhood, the nearby park, and the underground sewers illustrate moving further and further from safety. The different environments and characters would look just as good on the pages of a glossy storybook as they do in motion, and impeccable voice acting from the entire cast plays a big part in making characters memorable.
Parkour, parkour, parkour! Woo!
You're the best, Pete.
Neversong is an enjoyably grim adventure. It feels like there are layers to its 4-hour-long story, and though I wish there was just a bit more to discover about the world, I don't regret the time I spent in it. Neversong released earlier this month on Apple Arcade and is out May 20th on PC for $14.99.